Hey everybody, it's April the 1st and I have some great news for you. God is still in control. Did you know that there were actually two pandemics spreading around our globe today? The first one you've heard a lot about, it's called coronavirus or COVID-19. It's infected people in over 150 countries around the world, hundreds of thousands of people, and we certainly want to pray for those who've been affected, who are sick. I have several friends who've contracted the coronavirus and are very sick right now. So we want to pray for them. But there's another pandemic that's spreading around the globe that I think could be even more dangerous than the coronavirus. It's a pandemic called fear. We see fear everywhere. We see it on our mainstream media. We see it in our social media. We see it through government officials. Fear sells. But I'm going to encourage you today to not be a buyer of the fear virus. As a matter of fact, I think that we should all be carriers of a third pandemic. That's right. I don't think two pandemics are enough. I think we need a third pandemic to spread across the globe today. This is not some kind of cruel April Fool's joke. Rather, I think we should all be patient zero for a pandemic called hope. It is just as contagious as these others. When you get a hold of hope and people see hope in your eyes and hope in your spirit and hope in your home, they'll want some too, and it could spread virally across the globe today. Our devotional thought comes from three scriptures today on hope. The first one is in Psalm 46, 1 and 2. God is our strength and refuge, always ready to help in times of trouble. So we will not fear when the earthquakes come and the mountains crumble into the sea. Job 11, verse 18, having hope will give you courage. You will be protected and will rest in safety. And then Hebrews 10, 23 and 24, let us hold tightly without wavering to the hope we affirm, for God can be trusted to keep his promise. Let us think of ways to motivate one another to acts of love and good works. I think hope should spread around our globe. With Palm Sunday and Easter coming up, it's a season of hope. It's a season of new life. And the hope that comes through Jesus could spread around the globe. More people are hearing the gospel than ever before, and you could be a part of that. Maybe you'd share this devotional about hope with one of your friends that you think needs it. Maybe you just share it on your timeline so all your friends can have hope. But we can be patient zeros for a third pandemic that will save the world. A pandemic called hope in Jesus. So I have a question for you today. Are you contagious? Not with the coronavirus, not with fear, but are you contagious with hope? I hope you are. And I want to pray that you'll be even more contagious in the days ahead. Can I pray for you? Jesus, thank you. Thank you for your presence in our lives. Thank you for the hope that only comes from you. Thank you that we can rest safely in you as your scriptures promise. And so we pray today, God, for hope to take root in our hearts and in our homes and on our faces for every Zoom call, for every FaceTime call. Lord, that people would see hope in our eyes and they would want a piece of what we have and that it would spread virally across the globe. Thank you, Jesus, for the hope that only comes through you, the hope that defeats death, hell, and the grave, the hope that we celebrate this time of year. I thank you, God, that it can fill every heart and every home within the sound of my voice. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. Would you do this? Would you go spread some hope today? God bless you. Have a great day. I'll see you tomorrow.